I want you to expand on the guarantee that we have. It's a question we get often from people that listen to the show.
Yep.
And I love having that conversation with folks that reach out to us. But I think if you could give just kind of a quick overview, obviously we don't want to give away all the secrets, right?
Right.
But give us a quick overview. How do we come to that number? What does that guarantee actually consist of? Because I think there's a lot of people that are curious about it. People hear a lot of guarantees out there.
Right.
And most of them are bogus.
Most of them are total bait and switch, bogus. Even in real estate. I mean, look. I'm not going to badmouth any one specific agent or company by name. That's not what we do. We don't even enjoy doing that. And plus, you know, my goal as a follower of Jesus is I'm not going to tear anybody down. We want to build people up and love on them, even if we don't necessarily agree with how they do business. It's a free country. You can do business a lot of ways, and they might be legal. We just don't think they're best.
Yep.
And so I have been in the room with trainers and coaches and consultants who say, it doesn't matter if you ever actually deliver on your promise, it just matters if it makes the phone ring. And I think that's total and complete garbage.
Yep.
I think it's unethical. I think it's really, really cruddy. So that is not what's happening here. When we say that we guarantee to sell your house over the average price and under the average time, we mean that we guarantee that we will sell your house, the one you're living in or own, to someone else for more money than the mathematical average of what other people are selling similar houses in the same neighborhood or similar area at the same time of year for. It also means that we guarantee that we will sell it faster than people who are selling similar homes in the same area the same time of year are selling it for. The mathematical average. Now, I know that it sounds like I just said the same thing because I did, because we mean what we say, because there's no misleading language in there. Literally, if you call us or email us or go online, we will connect you with one of our experts. They will do an assessment, a legitimate deep dive value, way more than comps, a deep dive valuation of your home. But more than that, they'll talk to you and listen to you and understand you and your timeline and your motivation and your family situation or your job situation or whatever it is, and say to you, hey, we think we would be a great fit to work together, or hey, I don't think we would be a great fit to work together. At any point, if we say that we believe we would be a great fit together and you also think we're a great fit to work together, at that point, we will show you the research we've done, make sure that you believe it's legitimate and agree with it, and establish this is the average price that homes are selling for in the neighborhood that we agree on, and this is the average time it's taking to sell them, and we'll agree on that. And then we will guarantee to sell the house for more money than that number that homes are selling for, and for faster, less days than the time it's taking to sell them. There's no trick. There's no bait and switch. There's no manufacturing crazy statistics. We share the data. We will come to an agreement. And there's one more point I want to make. And this is one that real estate agents who are tuning in, and we have a lot of agents that listen to the show that have great feedback, but a lot of them are not going to like what I'm about to say, because I'm going to expose an absolute trick that real estate agents use to take advantage of individuals and the marketplace as a whole. Are you ready?
I'm ready. Let's go.
Here we go.
Ready.
List to sales price ratio. Okay.
Yeah.
List to sales price ratio. Now, let me say this up front. Most agents and title companies and mortgage lenders, and I believe newspaper writers and radio hosts and a lot of people, don't even know they're doing this. So they're, all the misleading stuff is happening, but I don't think that most of them are aware how misleading they're being. I think some of them know, but most of them don't. Here's why. If I tell you that as a company, our ratio of list price to sales price, which means how much did we ask for the house and how much did we get for the house, right? It sounds like a really good number to track, right?
Right.
We are at, you know, this isn't our number, but people say this. We're at 98.8% list to sales price ratio, which means on average, we get 98.8% of what we're asking for homes. That sounds awesome.
I like it.
Now, sounds let me good. Make one very simple point that will destroy your confidence.
But I
in
like
that, number.
That, though. I like
Yeah, it feels good, right? You can yeah. curl up with that at night and stay warm. Here's the deal. I can ask whatever I want for the house. List price is not required to be based on any research, any factual data, or even any thinking. I could literally just type whatever number I want into the MLS database. Now,
I like the percentage a little bit less.
A real estate agent can't do that without approval from their client, but you, I'm sure you could imagine the ways a client might not know or might want a crazy number, or an agent might encourage a client to underprice their home so it's easier to sell.
Of course.
I'm not accusing any one agent, any one company, any brokerage. Uh-oh. It's conspiracy theories. Here we go. But can you see how absolutely common that might be, because someone else in your office did it that way, or your broker did it that way, or people have always done it that way, so you do it that way. You're not deliberately cheating people, but you're saying, hey, we average X percentage of what we ask. Well, who cares? Were you asking the right amount? We do research all the time where we tell people, look, you can offer full asking price because their asking price is way low.
Yeah.
Or, hey, I wouldn't pay anywhere near that because their asking price is crazy high, right? So what we do is we say, here's what homes have actually sold for in the neighborhood. Very recently, very similar homes. Only difference being the agent who is marketing it or selling it. And we will guarantee that we will sell it for more than that. And right now, we're averaging almost 9% more than that. In DFW right now, the average homes that we're selling is a little over $300,000. That's $27,000 or more dollars more in your pocket that you can go do whatever you'd like with.
I want to add one thing too that's really, really important, is that we're not just having one person take a look at all of this. We have at least three people take a yeah. look at every single property. At the value of it, yeah. because the reality is one person can miss something.
Right.
Right? Three people yeah. collectively are probably not going to miss on a price.
And while we're picking on the average typical agent, let me just say this. The average agent's going to sell 6 or 7 or 8 houses a year, and 4 or 5 of those are going to be buyers. So they're going to work with 1 or 2 or 3 sellers a year. That's just kind of the average numbers. On our team, that agent's only working with sellers, and they're probably selling 40 or more homes that year.
Our list, our marketing specialists on average this week have 4 homes each going live.
Right, which is absurd because most agents wouldn't do that amount in a year.
Right.
And they're doing more than that this week, doubling it.
Yeah!
There you go, Lil John. So it's exciting for us as a team, and it's not intended to brag, although I'm thrilled to brag on our team members and share about that with the marketplace. But for our friends, our neighbors, our audience, you need to know that that statistic means nothing. I could be at 110% of list to sales price ratio, meaning I average selling homes for 10% more than we ask, because we always ask 15% low, which means we're selling all of those houses 5% below what they should sell for. I hope that made sense.
It does make sense. And I want to make sure it's really, really clear that whenever you're saying that we average 9% over
almost
average
9%,
price,
yeah. yep.
that's very, very different
very
to say
different.
9% over list of sales.
Right. But let me just clarify the difference one more time, because we've got a bunch more to cover. What we're saying is we're averaging almost 9% more than other homes are actually selling for, as opposed to saying we're getting 98% of what we asked for the house.
Very different.
Because you could ask way high. And right now in this market, believe it or not, a lot of people are asking low. They're leaving a ton of money on the table.